Good evening and welcome. Everybody, I'm David Bell. I'd like to welcome you to David Bell's Tong Sudo Show. Tonight, pretty exciting night. I'm being joined, first of all, one of my students, a lot of years, 5 or 6 years now, Matthew Gerzet. Got a little special something for you. The last couple of shows I've been doing, The Road to Master. There is one particular hyung that we're going to be working on tonight. And this is a fourth level hyung introduced to a practitioner in third degree black belt. But it's required to go into the fourth dan. It's called Kun San Kun. Kun San Kun is a 300-year-old hyung from said to be created in the southern part of China, named from a Chinese missionary, Kun San Kun. And that's what I want to take young Rizé through tonight. Very early in his training to be even going through this hyung, but he's a veteran black belt, young veteran black belt. So we started him to work on that form, and maybe pick it up in the next 6-7 years, and he'll be ready to test for his master. And he can say, I've been doing this form 6 years now. And in Tong Sudo, that's kind of the way we train. So I want to give him a little introduction to the hyung. And that's what we're going to be doing tonight. It's just walking through it and defining the moves in the hyung. And I think this will be very exciting. So you guys just stay tuned tonight. You ready to walk through it?
Yes, sir. See?
Back. This one, Kun San Kun. 67 moves. What I want to do with Mr. Grisey is just take it from the very beginning, from Chumbi, then Kun San Kun, Chumbi, and just kind of talk about it and walk through it. Just kind of flow through it for a little bit. Okay?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to try to just how we used to do Korean march or so, but I won't key out for you. So you'll hear me breathing, we'll just move. We've worked together enough so you can kind of feel. We just gotta have fun with this, okay?
Yes, sir.
And even if there's some moves that you don't quite understand, we'll stop and talk about it, and then we'll pick up and go. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So, from here. To me. Now this is ready stance for us. What we've done at this point was just becoming rigid with the earth from here. Okay? But we're gonna be doing this pretty much soft. So from here, we go into what we call Kun San Kun Chumbi, which will just be a very flowing little move. And what I have done at this point, if you can see, I have built what we call a pyramid, kind of like a watch glass pyramid. And from this point, when we began, Shizhong, so bring it up, raise it up, the eyeglass, seeing your whole world right through that pyramid, right at the top, flip it back, there, and then begin, open, and bring the world down. And let your eyes come down level as your hands come down. When you get about waist wide, you start to sink your cheek in to here. And you come here. So let's go back to that part. So you hear? To me. Kun San Kun.
Kun San Kun, sir.
To me. Jizhou. Yeah. this particular move from here, there are five moves that we take from our pyeong forms. So basa hyeong. From here, you come back to the center. There's one, two, three, four, five. First, strike to the neck, solar plexus, block, and the shunku, back to the solar plexus, and block again. Okay? Here, block, middle pseudo block, and the kwan su.
Oh, yeah.
This is up high, comes down into the solar plexus.
Oh, yeah.
Here. Turn, look. Ball come down over the head, block it. Kick and step. Hukou. Bang. That's nice. Blocking the ball. Step. Shunku. Back to Hukou. Hukou. So. Good. That point. Behind. This. Now, from here, this will represent a midsection side kick. Bam! I kick him here, his head come forward. Bam! And grab. Here. That's what we're doing here. So, from this point here, center. Here, blocking the bow again. Strike back fist to the chest. Step back quickly. Inside, outside, block. Okay? Step. And turn. Okay? We're going to turn to the left. Here. Come back. Bam. And air. Wow! And here. Up. Yeah. Turn. Yes. Okay. Turn. And back. Run it. So. So. Sen Kun, 67 moves, and just learning it. I just thought it would be interesting to show how I introduce new forms to the junior students. So we're walking through it slowly. So I think this probably things you can pick up watching. I think the even though we're trying to do it soft, the level of focus and concentration, the patterns of breathing with the movement, hopefully just watching the show, you still pick up a sense of very intense practice, but relaxing at the same time. And what I'm trying to do, and the way I've studied, is to try to bring the mind, even though you're focusing strong, but bring the mind, then the body, hard sometimes technique, but still the mind is there, and then the breathing pattern. So you have a balance. So that's how we can work out so strong and hard and have a sense of balance. And I think in viewing, it should give you a sense of relaxation. I don't know. I've had some interesting calls. So you guys call me if anything you don't understand about this philosophy. Now I'll try to talk with you more about it. But let's walk through it again, okay?
Yes, sir.
I just want to say again, just remember that this form, I mean, for 300 years, that this form has been around. And it just, something just don't stay around that long for no reason. Okay? So there's something here. Now we have to find out what it is.
Yes, sir.
Yes? Jimmy. Kunsen-kun.
Kunsen-kun, sir.
Jimmy. This time, I think we'll kind of put a wrap on it. You're pretty loose at this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We'll make it a little bit more intense. We'll try not to take it up to master level yet. But we'll make it a little bit more intense. Have a little bit more fun with it. So did you have any questions about it before we get into this one?
On that last move, I like to imagine an opponent, so I'm wondering what my opponent is doing when I'm doing that move right there.
Well, when you do that jump from here, in your back, right here, right? Something is happening when you do that kick to the opponent. Hurrah! Hurrah! They grab that. Hurrah! Boom. Okay? Something happened with that kick. That something got stuck on that leg. So that's your signature movement. Done.
Yes,
all right, try again.
Yes,
you get that feel. And another thing, when you land, try to land in a good long stance like that. So you don't have to bend over and do this from here. Wow.
Yes,
okay, so see what you got right there. Yeah. Okay?
Yes, sir.
I probably could teach you better than I can do it, so I just want to let you know. Long and low.
Yes, sir.
If you see me boom like that, it's like past 40.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Okay, we'll do it one more. Three, two. Kun San Kun.
Kun San Kun, sir.
To me. Thank everybody for joining in, and I want to take this opportunity to just kind of express the experience of that form. And I want to express also, I've been training almost 30 years now. When we say moving into master, it really doesn't mean that we've mastered anything. We just train. We set up training for life. Martial artists train as long as they're alive. There is no retirement. It is trained in martial arts. Martial arts become a way of life. The forms I teach, in the very beginning students, probably my most enjoyable forms. They're the ones that I'm most familiar with. So in this particular form, Kun San Kun, it's a long, challenging form. So I don't proclaim to have mastered that form, and I don't want you to sit out there and think, this master, he's master. No, we're training on this form. I'll be doing this form for the rest of my life, and every time I do it, I'll be trying to improve on something. I'd like to thank Mr. Grisette, and just like I say, he's 18 years old now. I'm very, very proud of where he is. I think he came to First Tong Sudo Fremont, which is now the Healing Arts Center. He came when I think he was 12 years old.
Yes, sir.
All over the place. It's all over. But it's been a joy training and working with him these last 6 years. What do you think about that? I've taught you a lot of forms.
Yes, sir.
How many forms do you think you know right now?
Over 20.
About 20 or 20, 21, something like that. What do you think about that particular one?
Takes a lot of endurance if you do it really to the max, because, mm-hmm. because we were doing it, you know, slow. I was mm-hmm. kind of falling behind, but 67 moves.
67 moves.
That's a lot.
That's a nice form. Nice form. And One thing, I'll take my black belt students or any student. He's adapted well, and he trains and practices what I try to teach him. So it's not beyond me to take him as a junior and teach him forms that I'm working on. I think the time that would be a mistake, if he was not into his forms for his level, really training, practicing hard on his forms, it would be an injustice to take him through that form. But Mr. Grisey has a regular routine of training. So then for me, it's nice to have a dedicated student with his training to be able to walk through forms that I'm learning. So thank you for that. That was beautiful. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And you keep it just like the rest of your forms. Just respect it and practice it, and hopefully 30 years down the road, you'll still be having fun. Okay?
Yes, sir.
How about if we maybe close it out with a...
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, if there's anything that I can, maybe information or anything you guys need, just call me now in the First Tone Studio Fremont, or ride by this new logo now, the Healing Arts Center. Give me a call then, okay? What? Too quick.
Paras.
Excellent.